Hello, I'm here at the Pictures at Play exhibition, and I'm with Sally Kindberg. Am I saying that right, Kim?
Yes, that's right.
Kindberg.
No, Kindberg.
Sally Kindberg.
No, yes. Kindberg.
And we're standing right in front of her picture. So here's her picture. It is blue like her hair. Sally, can you talk about your picture a little bit?
Yeah. It's a page from the comic strip History of Space. And space was always something that I was really interested in.
Sorry, that's a published book, right?
Yeah. Published by Bloomsbury. And I collaborated, it was a 50-50 collaboration with a writer called Tracy Turner, who's a brilliant writer. And we first of all did the history of the world, but when we'd done the history of the world, we thought, well, what are we going to do next? So we did the history of space, and here it is. Here's a page from it.
Now, so how long does it take you to draw something like that, a page?
Yeah,
like that?
The book took me about 6 months because I did all the text, all the handwriting myself. But that was slightly problematic to my publisher because they wanted to, when they do foreign editions. That's a bit of a problem. So the next one.
Can you explain what a foreign edition is?
Okay. Yeah. Well, this is if a publisher from abroad wants to do it, and they want to do it in their language. Obviously, the content of the speech bubbles has to be in their language. And if it's if you do it yourself, it's all on the on one surface, so it's easier if there's an overlay. So what happened was in the next book we did, which was comic strip history of comic strip myths, my publisher Bloomsbury made a font out of that's an alphabet out of my handwriting, so they could drop it in. Because in fact, the history of space and the history of the world was translated into Chinese, which was even more complicated, actually. But then they could fit the text.
But Chinese is like characters. I mean, how do you fit characters into?
Well, as long as the speech bubbles are big enough. I don't know how they match the content because I don't speak Chinese. So. But that was very exciting. So I've got a copy of the book in Chinese, and it looks beautiful because I love the calligraphy. You know, I love the typography rather. So there you are.
And how many pages is the book?
79. So we did, our first book was The History of the World in 79 pages, but when we pitched to publishers, I did The History of the World in 7 frames, but it was a bit depressing because everything, but we were hoping for a bidding war, but we didn't quite get that. But Bloomsbury was very keen to do The History of the World, and then we thought, we've blown it, because what else are we going to do? We've done the whole world. So we did space as well.
Well, space deserves that kind of coverage. Thank you very much, Sally.
Thank you, Candy.
And here's a last look at the picture. I'll carefully frame it for you. Is that right?
This is some space pioneers, these early space pioneers, which were animals.
Who were animals.
Yes, yeah, because the very first animals or living creatures that were sent into space were actually fruit flies. I know. But my heroines, my space heroines, are these two spiders called Anita and Arabella, who were the first spiders in space. Yeah. Managed to spin a web. It was a bit wonky, but they managed to spin a web while they were in orbit, which I think is very exciting.
Well, that is very exciting. Thank you, Sally.
Can I say something about my event?
She wants to say something about her event. Okay. All right, she's going to say something. It's a plug, so you can kind of go make tea. Oh, here, go, say something.
Okay. I'm doing an event at this wonderful theatre, Half Moon Theatre, on the 7th of October.
7th of October.
Yeah, here, and it's free, and I'm going to be telling space stories and drawing them live and getting kids to draw afterwards, and it's going to be really exciting, and it's called Wooshy Wonders, and it's extraordinary stories about space adventures.
Wooshy Wonders, I'm going, bye.